It is August of 2016, which means that the Summer Olympics are in full swing in Rio de Janeiro, where Usain Bolt, the fastest man in the world that we currently know of, will be attending. Which made me wonder, how fast could we run? Many of us dream of being able to run as fast as Usain Bolt or The Flash, and we all know of Usain Bolt's famous 100-meter run in the 2008 Beijing Olympics, where he ran the whole of it in 9.69 seconds. Averaging around 37 kilometers per hour. So how does he run like that? Well, one answer is in a runner's stride. A stride, of course, being the amount of distance a runner covers from lifting one foot off the ground to putting the next foot on the ground, if you didn't already know that. Obviously, if you increase the distance covered in each individual stride, while still maintaining an average pace of around 4 strides per second, you'll run faster. This is important to know, as even the fastest elite sprinters don't take any more strides per second than an average runner. It takes an average person around 55 strides, touching ground for 0.12 seconds per stride to complete the 100-meter race, whilst professional sprinters can do this in 45 strides, touching ground for around 0.08 seconds per stride. Sprinters like Usain Bolt can achieve this through a variety of different ways, including but not limited to shoes which give you a firm grip on the ground during those short times you're touching the ground. This is a very key thing. In fact, for this very reason, a cheetah's claws never fully retract, allowing it to have an excellent grip on the ground as a Serengeti. It also, of course, helps to have longer legs and more muscle mass, especially fast twitch muscles, which are generally the white meat of that former Olympic chicken you ate. And it, of course, also helps to have tons of practice and training. So how fast could we run? Well, Usain Bolt is the fastest human that we know of. However, he is not by any means the fastest human possible. In fact, 17,000-year-old footprints from ancient Australia have been found belonging to an individual scientists simply refer to as T8. T8 has been calculated to have been running at around 37 kilometers per hour, which, while that is as fast as Usain Bolt, not any faster, keep in mind he was running barefoot across the muddy, scorpion-infested landscape of ancient Australia. If he had been running on a track like this one, or what Usain Bolt was running on, or in shoes like these, or what Usain Bolt has, then he could have easily reached 45 kilometers per hour. In fact, research on the reactivity of human leg muscles shows that we could potentially run at up to 65 kilometers per hour, which, while not enough to escape from a cheetah, is still faster than the airspeed velocity of an unlaying swallow, and it is fast enough for you to run away from a grizzly bear. This, however, does not mean you should, under any circumstances, run away from a grizzly bear. That's not even a dare. That's not a dare. Don't do it. So, what's really holding us back? Well, really, to explain it quickly, our hips and legs are not built for running fast, even by bipedal standards. Our hips and legs evolved for over 50 million years in the trees, and weren't, until recently, adapted for ground life. However, we are insanely good at running insanely long distances and wearing down prey. So, if you ever read The Tortoise and the Hare, then you'll know that that kudu you're chasing but is leaving you in the dust is still soon to be a coup d'etat.
Alright, well, according to Snapchat, I can only run at 17 kilometers per hour, so I should probably just stick to making YouTube videos every Sunday and almost every Wednesday. So if you want, you can subscribe for more on those dates. See you next week and stay positive.